WWE try to set their talent up for success if they believe in them. This is why many have grand debuts, which were to get them off on the right foot. Despite this, over the years in their career, these talents fall out of good graces with the company and become nothing more than filler pieces on the roster. This is Wrestling Hub, my name is John, and these are 10 massive WWE debuts that failed.
The Mexican High Flyer.
We begin with one of the most infamous instances of a wrestler who debuted with a lot of hype before his career turned into a disappointment. After WWE poached the biggest star in the Lucha Libre world by signing Mystico, they made grand plans for him. They were looking to capture the Hispanic market, one they already had attention from with Rey Mysterio and Alberto Del Rio. Cara debuted in a singles match against Primo, but had a high-profile press conference announcing his signing with the company. Sin Cara had a solid run for a few months before the wheels started coming off the wagon. He was popped for a wellness policy violation for drugs he took while recovering from a knee injury in Mexico. His constant injury saw WWE split time between him and Junico with Sin Cara, which later led to an underwhelming feud between the pair. His refusal to learn English caused issues in the ring with other talent, and his poor attitude towards learning WWE style meant he'd leave the company with virtually no accolades.
After conquering the land of the rising sun, Nakamura hopes his fortunes will continue to rise on sports entertainment's colossal stage as he looks to make an indelible first impression, just like his opponent Zayn did in 2013.
Shinsuke Nakamura's debut on NXT was one of the most anticipated on the brand. WWE just poached four top stars from New Japan and AJ Styles, Karl Anderson, Luke Gallows, and Nakamura in early 2016. While AJ was obviously the big acquisition, everyone was touting Nakamura as one of the next big stars. His debut on NXT saw a featured match against Sami Zayn at TakeOver Dallas. The match was the best bout of the night and would have fans chanting Fight Forever, as it was Zayn's goodbye from NXT. Nakamura would have a few strong years on NXT serving as their champion before another electrifying debut on SmackDown, where he came out to a live violin and an electric crowd. He would even go on to win the Royal Rumble 2018, but after that win, WWE booked his character into suicide. Nakamura would turn heel and start low-blowing his opponents, undermining everything he had done. Now Nakamura is an afterthought and not even a shadow of the superstar he debuted as in 2016. We go from one NXT legend to another. Sami Zayn debuted on NXT before it became a commercial entity, so we're going to primarily talk about his main roster debut. After helping NXT become more than just a developmental promotion with his feuds against Cesaro and Kevin Owens, his main roster debut was long awaited and came opposite John Cena in his US title open challenge to a raucous pop. Zayn's downward spiral would begin on that day as he tore his shoulder before even entering the ring. Nonetheless, the pair had a great match, with Cena publicly endorsing Zayn after. Sami's career never really took off after WWE pigeonholed him in his feud with Kevin Owens. His underdog fire kept getting lost in the shuffle as he dealt with various injuries. After finally winning a singles title becoming IC champion, Zayn relinquished his belt, refusing to wrestle during a pandemic. His outspoken nature backstage that goes against WWE's policies means he will never be any bigger than he already is, despite his big debut against a 16-time world champion in John Cena.
God. Ladies and gentlemen, we've been hearing about this man for months. We once described him as the most sought-after free agent in WWE history.
Lars Sullivan's WWE career may as well be over with everything that has happened in the last 2 years. From being in a 5-star NXT match to having one of the most promoted debuts in recent history, Sullivan seems like he's already too broken to be repaired. Before, WWE were pushing his debut, and his first major opponent was to be John Cena at WrestleMania. Sullivan first had an anxiety attack, ruining his match against Cena, then his past homophobic and anti-Semitic posts were found, and after that his gay porno leaked. Sullivan may still have a career ahead of him, but not one that lives up to high standards his debut laid out.
It's time! Not wasting any time!
Taz's short-lived wrestling career in WWE is often forgotten. He is mostly remembered for his commentary, a position he took up 2 years after debuting as a wrestler. His debut was possibly one of the most shocking and should have set him up for success. He answered Kurt Angle's open challenge at the 2000 Royal Rumble and would out-wrestle him before ending Angle's undefeated streak in a huge upset. Taz would be sent to ECW to become their champion in a confusing story, but would appear on SmackDown as champion and lose clean to Triple H, sucking all the momentum out of his win over Angle. Vince McMahon has since spoken about how he regretted the decision to have Taz lose to Triple H. Taz would never recover, and by the 2001 Royal Rumble, he was such an afterthought that he was just one of the 11 that Kane eliminated in the Royal Rumble. Taz lasted just 10 seconds, the shortest time of any competitor in that match. You could argue whether the Great Khali's career was successful or not. Considering how talentless he was in the ring, it's remarkable he achieved the little he did. Khali debuted as an absolute monster, destroying The Undertaker on SmackDown. He would go on to squash World Heavyweight Champion Rey Mysterio and Taker in matches, before becoming champion. His debut was the perfect way to introduce a monster. Despite his sustained push, it became evident Khali was limited in the ring due to his size and lack of mobility. He would fall down the card after losing his heavyweight title to Batista, then being defeated by John Cena on Raw over the WWE title. He would become a comedy character after 2008, hosting Kiss Cams and being used as comic relief, and would leave by 2014. After Bloom returned from a successful stint in Japan, WWE were excited to welcome him back with a push. The company tried this in the early 2000s, but the then A-Train's limited skill set prevented them from doing so. Tensai would win his debut match against Alex Riley on Raw. He went on to dominate former WWE champion John Cena, as Cena was just off his loss to The Rock at WrestleMania 28. The fans wholly rejected the goofy Tensai gimmick, chanting Albert during his matches. This would lead to the rug being pulled out from under him as he went on to lose his undefeated streak, then enter a comedy tag team with Brodus Clay, but is now the head of the Performance Center. Diamond Dallas Page offered a lot for WWE when he jumped from WCW. As opposed to sitting out and collecting a paycheck for a year, DDP signed a WWE deal, debuting as an opponent for The Undertaker, but DDP was a stalker, which was strike one for his WWE career. It was meant to make him a top heel going up against Undertaker, yet WWE ruined the angle. It would end with the Brothers of Destruction defeating Page and Canyon in a steel cage. The dud storyline followed by DDP getting injured meant the former WCW champion would lose momentum and leave the company about a year after he debuted, picking a fight against the biggest dog in the yard.
You know what? I actually never thought I'd want to see this guy. But that's Carlito Caribbean Cool. He's debuting tonight here, and I guess Carlito.
Carlito made a bigger impact on his debut than most, but his career did not live up to that initial showcase. He showed up on WWE TV as Carlito Caribbean Cool, an apple-spitting man who has a problem with people that don't want to be cool. It was a unique character WWE seemingly attached a rocket to, as Carlito beat rising star and US champion John Cena in his debut. Carlito would use the tactic Cena did to win the title against Big Show at Mania 20 by knocking him out with a steel chain. Carlito would go on a streak as champion, defeating the likes of Eddie Guerrero, Rey Mysterio, and Rob Van Dam. Though this momentum would slowly run out, despite WWE still keeping Carlito in the upper echelons of the card. He would move to Raw, but kept having runs with the Intercontinental and Tag Team Championship. He'd be out of the company by 2010 because of a painkiller addiction, undermining how his hot debut fizzled out into an average career. The Nexus had one of the greatest debuts. A group of WWE rookies stormed the main event of a high-profile Raw match between John Cena and CM Punk, laying out the former champions. They decimated the ring and staff, making one of the greatest opening statements. Their debut was followed up well for a few weeks, including laying out a stroke victim in Bret Hart, but would meet its end at the hands of John Cena, who at SummerSlam 2010 beat the last two members of Team Nexus, Justin Gabriel and Wade Barrett, as the final member of Team WWE after taking taking a DDT to the unpadded floor on the outside. They tried salvaging the angle, but the momentum was gone, and no one except Daniel Bryan from the original Nexus still wrestles for the company. And remember, Bryan was a part of Team WWE in this match. Cena would repent by losing matches at the next 6 SummerSlams until he defeated Baron Corbin in 2017. And these were 10 massive WWE debuts that failed. I hope you're all having a great day. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you later in the next one.